Hello, students. Now this is the time to study the vocabulary of the first lesson together. Before we start, let's pray briefly. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to study your word. As we will study about the Gospels, Synoptic Gospels, and the life of Jesus, what he did and what he taught for us, please be with us with the Holy Spirit that we may understand and grow in the Lord. Thank you so much for hearing our prayers, and we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Hi, students. About the introduction page, we have already talked about it in the introduction video, how we will proceed with the classes. Here we will do the vocabulary study. And the first lesson's title is Theology of the Synoptics. We will look at about 20 vocabularies this time. The first one we will look at is soon or syn. Actually, it's a Greek word and it means with or together. It's a Greek prefix. Which is put in front of the Greek word. And the next one is optanomai, which means to be seen. And the word synoptic gospels come from these two words combined. Syn optic gospels, syn optanomai, syn optanomai. So the Synoptic Gospels means that they are looked at from the same viewpoint. That's why they are so similar, even though there are many differences. And there are three books in the Synoptic Gospels: Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Those three Bible books are called Synoptics or Synoptic Gospels together. So that word came from the Greek word syn and optanomai. Next word we want to look at is the word exegesis. Exegesis means critical explanation or interpretation of a text, especially of scripture. Hepister said, "With Jesus Christ, there was no conflict between doctrinal statements and the experienced biblical truth." Exegesis is studying of the text itself, what the words means and how they are related together and what it means in the context of when it was written. In comparison with exegesis, systematic theology means a form of theology in which the aim is to arrange religious truth in a self-consistent whole. In a self-consistent whole is probably an important word, because in the systematic theology, you ask, what is soteriology? What is the salvation? How about Christ? And how is the end of time? You ask that kind of questions in the systematic theology. Hepister says, doctrines are the formalized aspects of the faith in our high calling, he said. The next word we will think about is descriptive and normative. We know descriptive. Descriptive means to describe how it is. And normative means establishing, relating to, or deriving from a standard or norm. Here I wrote, the apostles as writers were not just descriptive of their own feelings about the truth, but set out normative truth packed into the text. Scholars like Brunner, Bultmann et al. Says the text is just descriptive and not normative. Adventists say it is edited by the Holy Spirit, thus it is normative. So actually the Bible texts are not only descriptive, but it is normative as well, because it suggests a standard or norm to ourselves, and this normative descriptive aspects are important for our gospel studies. Next one we want to think about is diversity and unity. There is not just one gospel, but there are four gospels, and they are different, and they portray diverse aspects of the life of Jesus and of the gospel. But they are not only diverse, but there is unity in the Bibles, in the Bible books. So there is diversity in unity, and there is unity in diversity. Let me read the below. It is the attitude that the synoptic text consists of a diversity of content to the point of contrasting each other. Unity is the way Adventists would describe this diversity, since they were just in space and time diverse, not in setting of alternative norms deviating from each other. So there is perfect unity. There is unity, but in the unity, you see the diversity, because the Gospels, three synoptic Gospels, are different with each other. Next one we want to think about is harmonious, cohesive, consistent. Especially when you do the systematic theology, you pursue for harmonious, cohesive, and consistent conclusions from studying the Bible. Let me think about cohesive here. When the part of the whole work or whole work together or fit together well, they are cohesive. The attempt by scholars to harmonize data, this seems for the eye to be contradictory statements. Adventists are attempting to bring a cohesive understanding of the data so that truth is consistent in both testaments. Next one we will consider is the word reduction. Reduction is the action or fact of making a specified thing smaller or less in amount, degree, or size. If there is only one gospel, then your understanding of Jesus is reduced, smaller in amount, degree, or size. But because there are diverse four gospels, your understanding is enlarged, and you have richer understanding about Jesus. It is the attempt to cut away from the total content aspects that they do not view as true, and then only come forward with the blank covers of the Bible. That means the understanding is reduced in your mind by the reductionism, but because of the diversity, you have richer understanding.